Welcome to Raptors Recon, and today's topic is a sad one. Hasn't been getting much traction in the news, but Rumen Petkoff passed away. So this is dedicated to him. Rest in peace, Rumen Petkoff. He lived from 1948 to 2018 and was responsible for a lot of kids' shows that we grew up with. So without further ado, let me go ahead and read the article. This article, you can find this basically on comicbookmovies.com, and it's titled Dexter's Laboratory and Powerpuff Girls Animator Dead at 70. Sad news as a wave of nostalgic sadness washes across anyone who watched Cartoon Network in the 90s with the word that one of the biggest influences of our childhood has passed. If you grew up in the late 1990s or early 2000s, chances are you are more than familiar with Cartoon Network and the series of shows that were produced back then in what many call the height of the station's animation days. Shows like Johnny Bravo, Cow and Chicken, Powerpuff Girls, Ed, Edd and Eddy, and many more are household names and instantly recognizable to anyone who was raised on television during that time period. Almost any young adult can look at the picture below and name off most of the characters. As you can see, anyone who viewed the station during the millennial period is familiar with a lot of these characters, even if they don't remember them at first. That is why it is with much sadness that we report that Rumen Petkoff, one of the brilliant minds behind a lot of these shows, is no longer with us. Petkoff is very notable in his home country of Bulgaria, but in the United States he never became much of a household name. In Bulgaria he is widely celebrated as he inspired many cartoonists and filmmakers and their work there. He even helmed the nation's first animated feature film, Treasure Island, which made its debut in 1982. Petkoff contributed heavily to a number of series on Cartoon Network, including, but not limited to, Dexter's Laboratory, Johnny Bravo, Powerpuff Girls, Cow and Chicken, and I Am Weasel. Working as a storyboard artist, a writer, and an animation director on these shows, there is no doubt that he had a significant influence on their tone and our childhoods in general. You can see Petkoff pictured below with a few of his beloved characters. Petkoff died at the age of 70 on June 11, 2018. While he lived a full life, it goes without saying that his contributions to the animation community will be missed, even if most people weren't familiar with his name. Which of Rumen Petkoff's Cartoon Network shows was your favorite? So, I put the pictures from the article in here, and I put up some of, you know, basically some images of the things that he's worked on, but, you know, it's just like this article said, we grew up with this stuff. You know, 70, you know, that's kind of young to be passing away. He was a great talent. For me, I mean, out of that group, I watched Johnny Bravo, definitely. I watched Dexter's Laboratory, even Powerpuff Girls, with my sisters at the time. And yeah, it's really sad. So anyway, I just wanted to relay that. I know it's kind of a downer topic, but I figured it might be something to get out and, you know, fire up some nostalgia, you know, take a look at some of the old shows that he had, you know, and just pay him a little homage in that way and remember what this incredible talent, what Rumen Petkoff did and how he impacted our childhoods growing up, those of our siblings and, you know, sons, daughters, etc. So anyway, it's Raptors Recon and I'm signing out.